China, and here we are where everybody wants to be right now.
This is what table tennis is all about.
There it is, he does it! Look at this, the fans, seventh heaven right now. And he takes it.
They are the world champions.
Chengdu is known as the hibiscus city. Plenty of greenery, foliage, flora and fauna in this wonderful place. It's also known, of course, for its panda bears. And we are at the high-tech zone with some fantastic facilities, in particular the sports center here for the 2022 ITTF World Team Table Tennis Championships finals. Chengdu hosting this for the first time, the sixth time that China is hosting this prestigious tournament where the greater good for the world of table tennis could be to play for their teams. This is what is the schedule for day two. We've already had good results there for Chinese Taipei and Sweden defeating their opponents. Romania and England 3-1 each. Barbara Wei here with me. We've got China now for the rest of the day. Host nation, I mean, nothing less than wins all the way through here. I mean, it's the big wigs, isn't it?
This is the big wigs. This is what everyone's been waiting for. And it's their debut at this event. This is their first team tie and everyone can't wait to see all the players. And what a great lineup from Team China. Fan Zhenzhou, Ma Long, and Wang Fuqing are their most famous players right now. It's going to be great.
And, you know, when we talk about David and Goliath matchups, I mean, this is probably as David and Goliath as it gets, right?
I think anyone who plays Team China might feel like David and Goliath. But this is truly a national sport for China and really an up-and-coming sport in the whole Pan Am region, which Puerto Rico is doing very well in considering their small island nation.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, what an experience for these guys here, for Puerto Rico, to be playing the very best, something that they may never, ever get to do otherwise in their careers.
And this is very special for them. What a great... It's great to just feel the ball from someone like Fan Zhendong. What an honor to be able to do that. And they also get to show the world how good they can play on table one.
Yeah, I mean, just imagine what that must be feeling like for them. Five games, of course, best of five, first to 11. I mean, we've talked about this yesterday, the nerves coming into this. Already a pretty imposing venue. You've been so incredible. We've both been impressed with this. But then you're playing China. Add to that, you know, there's going to be a little bit of support here as well. It's got to be intimidating, right?
It's so intimidating. And these are probably your heroes, right? You've watched them play, you've been inspired by them, and now you're facing off against them across the other side of
right.
the table.
Well, look, I mean, I think you and I have discussed this earlier today. It's about gaining that experience, about what you can glean from your opponent, you know? And you can only come out better for it, right?
And you can take that experience and bring it back to Latin America, to Puerto Rico, to help the next generation. And it's just fun. Isn't it fun to play your idol?
Oh yeah, absolutely. This would be such a treat for these guys. I'm sure they cannot wait to get stuck in here. It does get much bigger than Fan Zhendong.
It really doesn't. I mean, definitely world number one, kind of the star, the face of Chinese table tennis. Others can argue Ma Long, who we'll see in the second match, is the star in the face, but Fan Zhendong has been just incredible over the last couple years.
What is it that you like so much about Fan Zhendong in his play?
I think he just almost never misses. We can sort of watch it today.
Yeah.
Just feel like he's so practiced, so perfect. Both
wings
are great.
Is this like the perfect player, the mold of a perfect player?
I would think so.
Yeah, right. So, Brian Affanato, I mean, he's got quite the task ahead of him, the 25-year-old. He's world-ranked 69. He's had 11 pro wins to his name, and he has a massive job on his hands.
And he is the top player from Puerto Rico, so he is their kind of top player, and hoping to learn a lot.
Fan Zhendong is 25 years of age. He's the world number one, as mentioned earlier by Barbara. 9 years of pro, 23 tournament wins. You can add Olympic gold as well from the Olympics last year, World Championships. He's won plenty in both team doubles and in singles, most recently in Houston
where you were at as well, watching him in action. What a treat he is, isn't he?
It's going to be. You should just watch Fentanyl for his form, for just how smoothly he moves.
Well, they've played twice before. Fentanyl Dong has won both of those. The highest reached by Brian Afanador. It's not too far away from where he's playing right now, which was number 60 in the world. So.
And those head-to-heads were from 2014. They're in the Youth Olympic Games.
Yeah.
So it's been a while.
Yeah, and a lot, of course, has changed since then for these two. Rebecca Birkfeld is in charge of this one. So just to remind you of who else is in this group, United States, Puerto Rico, Malaysia, and Canada make up these groups. Puerto Rico, excuse me, I'm looking at the women's side of it. My eyes are deceiving me.
So for the men's, it's also US, Puerto Rico, Thailand, and Slovenia in their group.
Thank you very much, Barbara. To my rescue. So, action to get underway here, very shortly indeed. Now, I mean, if you're Brian Afanador now, what are you looking to do? What are you looking to get out of this?
Right, I think you just want to show the world what you can do, right? You don't have to try to play like Fentanyl. You just play like you and make your shots.
So don't worry about him so much.
Right, just play,
worry about your
play
game.
Out, play
yeah.
out, play, relax, and there's nothing to lose. Like we're getting started, and we have some fans who are clapping.
First game.
Yeah, they'll be.
China to serve.
Really, really pleased that this is getting underway now. China, the tournament starts here for them. Let's go.
Just a master class.
Yep, that's exactly what the fans wanted to see. Just way out of the reach of Afanador there.
And look how smooth Fentanyl looks. He's just gliding over the table. Effortless work.
Absolutely. Well, he needs to hit his marks as much as he can, right? I mean, that's all he can do.
Absolutely. You just want to play your best, right? Even if the score doesn't reflect that, you just want to make sure you hit your shots and not be intimidated by the scene.
Four love.
Well, he's looking imperious already. And we have to be clear, China, they may be playing a minnow here, but they're going to take this as serious as any other match, and they're going to be clinical.
Absolutely. In Houston, they were clinical from the very first stages all the way through the end.
That is the way they're trying to play. These points are coming thick and fast, aren't they, for Phantom Goal?
And if you watch Brian Afanador, he's actually staying in the point. It's just Fentanyl can just keep going. Like I said, he just doesn't miss.
Love six.
Well, already 6 points on the board. We've been playing maybe 3 minutes now. Yeah, he's finding it tough dealing with that pace coming at him.
And just hitting more balls than Fentanyl. Fentanyl, like I said, if you watch him practice, you'll be so impressed.
Love six.
First point on the board for Brian Afanador. Comes off an error from Fentanyl. Short-lived any hope of perhaps putting a run of points together.
Fentanyl just looks so relaxed. Like, everything just feels easy. And of course, he's being very clinical and focused, but it's just how he's moving.
Sorry.
just a different level. And he is world number one for a reason.
There is a little delay here on the scoring. You know, Brian Afanador did take a game off Van der Tong at the Youth Olympics. That's a
7-1
consolation to him back in the day, so he knows it can be done. I mean, just a matter of 8 years ago, but looks like we're going perhaps manual.
8-1. One nine,
and it's just 2 points away now for Van der Tong to wrap things up.
Just showing how dominant he is as a player.
Oh, lovely return. Well done, Brian Afanador.
Again, he just wants to play his game.
Yeah.
That's it. Just do what you do in training. And now you get to feel it from Van der Tong. You get to play against him and learn from it.
That was a lovely shot from him there. Game points
two.
In hand for Van der Tong.
Yeah,
stripping the net perhaps along the way, but Van der Tong cruises through that in double quick time against Brian Afanador. He's looked so comfortable, hasn't he?
Man, look at his form. It's just so perfect to watch. Van der Tong is actually known for his backhand, but his forehand is super strong too. Like I said, he just feels like he doesn't miss.
Yeah, he's not missing much at all. Not missing anything really at the moment. I love how he still has to talk to the coach, who's fairly animated and gesticulating. I'm not sure what more he can tell Van der Tong at this moment in time.
Traerlo adelante, empuja, el sub y nos vamos por arriba. Pero no, hay que matar la bola.
All the best, I think, is the message to Brian Afanador. What more can you say, really?
It is really an apt message.
Yeah. Second game, Puerto Rico to serve, love all. 1-1.
You can see that Van der Tong's every single shot has so much quality. Even if Brian Afanador is sitting there with his backhand, it just flies off the table.
2-love.
And I guess, and you're from that region as well, is if you're based there, you're also not facing the quality of opponent regularly, are you?
No, I mean, you're playing mostly in the Pan Am region, right?
They're
all of North and South America and Central America. It's hard to find a practice partner like Van der Tong.
Right. And that's why, you know, yesterday we were doing Brazil and talking about Eric Jorty. He trains and lives in Portugal to get a little bit more exposure to different kind of partners that he may not necessarily face back home.
You just see the quality from Van der Tong. Ryan is sitting there with his racket in the right position. It's just each shot's going off the table because of Van der Tong's own spin.
First point on the board for Brian Afanador.
He's being
now maneuvered around. He's 4-1 up here, or 1-4 at the moment. Afanador's
4-2.
That's about as emphatic a shot as it gets for Van der Tong.
2.
Went into the Olympics last year as the favorite. Even Ma Long said he was a favorite, but then went on to beat him
sometimes
in the final.
Sometimes it's tough to play kind of your big brother on the team. I'm sure Fenton will get his chance.
He will.
He was looking at, for sure, looking at Paris 2024.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. He's now up by 5 points here. 7-2 up. Oh, wow.
7-3.
Something a little bit different. And he's got his third point.
And what a fun point this was. Check this out. Such nice, like a chop block, and then beautiful side spin backhand.
That led there from Brian Afanador.
8-3.
I mean, Fenton looks like sweating.
He has a broken sweat here, yeah. That says a lot. And we can tell you it's very warm out there.
3-9.
Fourth point on the board here, Brian Afanador. Feel not happy about that, I'm sure.
10-4.
Just stretching Fenton Tong a little bit.
Yeah, this is much more dynamic than the first game. And the cool thing about playing, being from the Pan Am region, is that you get to be kind of creative. You know, everyone's kind of creating their own styles. There's no right way.
11-4.
And that's especially true coming from the Latin American region.
Fenton Tong has wrapped that one up better from Brian Afanador overall. Got stretched at times. And he takes that second one. 11-4 Fenton Tong. Two up here, the paddler from China.
No puede ser corto aquí para después repetirla ahí, porque cuando él viene te la coge aquí. Es una corta aquí y la diagonal para allá y es para matarla después. Esa juega la como tú quieras. ¿Eh? ¿Estás de acuerdo?
Sí, claro. Vamos allá,
so into game three here, Fenton Tong wins this, and it's the first match done and dusted. Wow.
Love one.
That just kicked up on him. That's unusual. About as close as it's been so far in this match, with scores level. The trick, of course, for Afanador is to maintain this.
2-1.
And that first time in this entire match, Afanador has the lead. Now, can he build on this? Great returns.
2-2.
Played well in that, Afanador. Shandong now takes that lead back.
Brian Asanago sort of nodding his head. He's like, this is right. This is the right thing I need to be doing right now. And it's okay that I didn't make it.
Yeah.
This is the right thing to do.
To show you just how imperious this player is, Phan Seng Dong. He has a career record of 86% that he's won. 222 matches out of 257. Absolutely outstanding.
I would say a lot of those losses are probably to Ma Long.
I was going to say, Ma Long's got a very slightly better win percentage at 87.
That just might be the difference.
Yes.
Timeout, Team Puerto
Time
Rico.
Out.
Well, I guess they would do one, I suppose. Not sure what more could be said to...
Lo más profundo que se pueda. Si es para arriba, pues no se puede.
Sí,
te metes en banana.
Sí,
pero si puede servir tu largo para allá abajo,
sí.
Y mira, te va a juega, juega el juego más,
sí,
libre.
Sí, más libre. Más libre.
Now we're back in action.
So, Brian Afanador, he's 3 points behind at the moment. Not insurmountable. In theory, at least.
Five,
it's had some
three.
Effect. This is good. Two behind. He's got a win percentage of 45% by enough and enough in comparison.
5-4.
And this is good.
A little bit of some straining from Phan Seng Dong on that loop.
We heard that, didn't we? Well, well, well. 5-5.
That timeout worked.
It has had some effect. Excellent. Not far away.
That's really great play from both sides. You know, if you're Brian Asanago, this is the kind of play you want to have. You're on table one, you want to show the world what you can do.
I can do that, right? Yeah. I can stand up and hold my own at times. Why not? Now that's that, for example, is an instance where he might be a little annoyed at himself, Brian Asanago, for not hitting his mark.
Right, because it's, he's like, I should have made that.
Yeah. So tell me, you know, Barbara, as a player, what annoys you more, missing something like that, or not taking the opportunity, or a winner against you, for example?
Oh, not taking the opportunity.
That upsets you more.
Absolutely.
Right. Because you'll feel, oh, well, I couldn't have done much about that winner.
Right, unless you kind of created the winner because you messed up the shot
right
before the winner.
So it's more about the frustration with yourself that you didn't put something away or didn't get the shot over.
That's right, because you know you can make it in training and how frustrating it is
right
to not
why
show it.
Why am I not
it
doing it now? Right. Not quite over.
6-8.
This is very competitive here at the moment in this game. Afanador, two away. Just look at who's in the background there. Warming up. Again, that would be an example of something that he would normally be able to put back, return at least, you think, in training?
Oh, this is a tough one.
Yeah.
at the end of a long rally. I think he was pretty close, so yeah. Looks like he feels okay about it.
Mm. Good work there on the backhand this time from Brian Affanato. That is the coach there for Puerto Rico, is the father of the Diaz sisters as well.
And he has really led the transformation of table tennis in Puerto Rico. Exciting to see him here.
Yeah, absolutely.
10-7.
And so we have three match points for Phan Xuân Dong. And he wraps it up. Phan Xuân Dong has won his first match. China off the mark here against Puerto Rico.
Clinical performance, but credit to Brian Affanato. He played very well.
Yeah.
Unfazed by the lights and the kind of
the
context and the occasion, exactly.
And he got better as the match progressed, as we'll see here. Phan Xuân Dong beating Brian Affanato 11-2, 11-4, 11-7 in three straight games. But as Barbara said, he gave a good account of himself, Brian Affanato. But it is one up here for China. And look who is getting ready there to play that next match. The great Ma Long is next. And he'll be playing Daniel Gonzalez.
Hey, we are here, day two of the World Team Table Tennis Championships Finals in Chengdu, presented by China Telecom, and we're really excited to see Team China. We had our first match, we got to see Phan Xuân Dong play Brian Affanato, and now for the GOAT, the greatest of all time, as many call him, Ma Long versus Daniel Gonzalez. So it's China versus Puerto Rico in the men's team group, and it's a superstar lineup from Team China. Ma Long has maybe too many titles to list in our short time here. Has won the World Championships, the Olympics, the World Cup, the Triple Crown, as we call it. And he has been the face of Chinese table tennis for the men's team for quite some time. Some fun facts, he was born in 1988, which is the year of the dragon, and that's why his name is Ma Long, Long meaning dragon. Coin toss looked like Ma Long chose, he won the coin toss and chose to receive.
2 minutes.
I'll get right into this 2 minute warm up. This is Daniel Gonzalez, 29 years old, right handed, world ranked 112. And world ranked 112 is a testament, again, to the growth of Puerto Rican table tennis over this generation. They've really put themselves on the map, especially in women's table tennis, and Daniel Gonzalez is just one of those players who's come out of that growth over the last decade or two. I'm Barbara Way, and I'm from the U.S., and I often see Daniel Gonzalez and the Puerto Rican team come to the U.S. to play some of our competitions, so it is great to see him here at the World Team Championships. And Malon, what can we say? He's world ranked number 2, but really, all table tennis fans know who he is. He's definitely the greatest of all time. And many people say he's one of the most balanced games. He's not the most powerful player. I think Fensterndl holds that. But Malon just seems to know where the ball is. He has really great intuition. And we'll see that on display in this match and in further matches throughout this event. Let's take a look at the head-to-head between these two. So this is their first meeting, and kind of what a treat to play Malon for the first time. Malon has the highest world ranking as world number 1, obviously. He's been a pro for 17 years compared to Daniel Gonzalez's world ranking 93 and 12 years a pro. They're both righty shake-hand attackers, so we'll see a lot of similar types of shots as we saw in the previous match with Fensterndl. Jonas Kivimaki is our umpire, and we are ready to get started.
First game. Puerto Rico to serve 0-0.
Great, go.
One, and Daniel Gonzalez picking up the first point. It's a great confidence booster. First 2 points. It's a really great start for the Puerto Rican. Again, this is Team China's first match of the event, so they're also making their debut here. And even for the GOAT like Malon, sometimes it takes just a couple points in the beginning.
1-2.
All eyes are on table one in this arena. Chinese fans excited to see some of their stars in action.
2-2.
Making an adjustment on the serve receive, pushing long. And again, 14 Puerto Rico, this is an opportunity to show the world what they can do. And clearly winning the first 2 points against Malon is not an easy feat.
4-2.
Again, Malon is such an intuitive player. He can kind of see that you're going the wrong direction and redirect that serve. We'll see a lot of great kind of GOAT level shots for Malon throughout this event, and we're just getting started today. First game of his first match.
2-6.
And again, Team China here, overwhelming favorites, but they're taking this very seriously. It's a clinical match, and they're using this opportunity as well to establish themselves and get settled in the arena at home.
Looks
like the umpire is asking Daniel Gonzalez to toss a little higher. And here's Jasmala's intuitive play. Just knows when you're going one direction and sends it the other. It's very frustrating as another player. Just feel like, hey, I thought the ball wasn't going to go there.
Fight.
7-3.
Nice play by Daniel Gonzalez. No, when you are the underdog and you're playing against Malong, you know, every point you win feels good. It feels like, hey, I'm good enough to rally with world number one, with the GOAT of table tennis over the last decade.
8-3.
Video of textbook shot from Malong. Take a look at that forehand right in the middle. Look at his windup and how far he swings. Just a perfect, beautiful forehand. And nice play by Daniel Gonzalez right into the middle. Nice play, nice spin. With Daniel Gonzalez, it's a little bit of side spin, and that very, very top. You can see Malone kind of reminding himself, hey, the ball bounces a little differently.
Stop. Please not blow into the ball. 9-5.
Umpire reminding Malone not to blow on the ball. There are new restrictions since the COVID pandemic.
9-6.
Hey, Daniel Gonzalez closing the gap now to 3 in the first game. Should feel kind of really proud of how far he's gone already.
6-10.
Malone does it clinically with that nice backhand. 11-6, takes that first game. Daniel Gonzalez, a great performance. You know, taking the first 2 points and kind of sticking with it, narrowing to a 3-point deficit at 9-6. But all eyes on Malone, who is here as kind of the anchor of the Chinese team. So 11-6 in the first game for Malong.
Vuelve el próximo abre. ¿Oye? El ataque está bien efectivo. Recuerda, una vez él saca el baja en cruzado, caqueta arriba, no trates de meterle más duro de lo que él le mete. Usa la de él. ¿Algo que decir?
Aprovecha a jugar.
Y verás bien el contacto de la pelota al final. Mira bien la jaqueta. Es una manera, un solo punto de darle a la bola. No se puede dar en dos puntos. Pues mira el punto donde se le da.
Él juega, él juega mucho al medio. Él juega a veces. Estoy esperando a la esquina y nunca viene.
Vamos a decir, recuerda, coge esa del medio cortito, al frente.
Back to the table for game two.
Second game. China to serve 0-0.
Malone not letting Gonzalez take a 2-point lead in the second game. No, it's great control, kind of pushing half long, just clear the edge of the table, makes it very difficult for your opponent to attack.
Zero, two. One.
Great serve and attack. Nice combination from Daniel Gonzalez. Let's take a look at that again. Steps around, straight down the line.
Three, one.
Clinical, just pounding that forehand cross court from Malong. Gotta be careful when you're serving to the goat. Any serve that's just a little long, a little high, you're gonna eat it. Gonzalez, lobbing is tough, and he did a great job, made that kind of comeback shot where he ran close to the table. Let's take a look at this. Look at that great touch from Malong as well.
One, five.
Malong truly is a great forehand player. So he truly favors his forehand. Can vary the spin, vary the speed. And his backhand is safer. It's still very, very good, don't get me wrong. But his forehand's definitely the weapon. He's just so comfortable turning the corner.
One, six.
Daniel Gonzalez picking up that next point. Now down 6-2. And this is something that has become a theme throughout the event, that if you're creative, if you do something a little different, that could actually mess people up. And that was a pretty creative shot from Daniel Gonzalez. Pick up that next point.
7-2.
Kind of taking it away here, extending the lead to 6, looking very comfortable. Great defense, kind of taking it. We're staying close to the table and blocking here instead of counter looping, but great placement on all of the blocks.
10-2.
Eight game points for Malong to go for a 2-0 lead in the best of 5. Just needs the
11,
one, takes it 11-2.
Second game to China.
And look at that forehand form. It's really textbook. Malong's forehand's been famous for, probably famous for a decade. Really rose to prominence around 2012. And hit kind of, well, he's been at the peak for a long time. Around 2015, 2016, when he reached world number one for the first time and held it. And now Fenton Dong and Ma Long are the leaders of the Chinese men's national team and icons in this country. look at the bench. Team China, Fan Zhendong, Liang Jingkun.
70% servicio corto, 30%.
Fan Zhendong, we saw earlier, Liang Jingkun, we're not going to see in this tie, but I'm sure we will see later on. And Lin Gaoyuan, not in that shot, but also on the bench, supporting their teammates in this opening round.
Third game, Puerto Rico to serve, 0-0.
Well, what a block from Daniel Gonzalez. I think he even, might have even surprised Malo. Was not enough to take the point from the go, but it was really, really great start for him. Looks like an edge serve. Daniel Gonzalez puts him on the scoreboard. Shot for Malo. Look at that side spin, extremely wide. I think it just nicked the edge. Not sure he even needed it.
Left. 1-3.
Lob from Daniel Gonzalez, kind of getting him back into it. Rallies with Malo after a string of points that were mostly won and lost on serve and serve receive. Must be great fun to lob to the goat. And watch Malo's serve, it's actually kind of the traditional pendulum service because you just swing it like a pendulum. It's highly deceptive, and it's one of the first serves you learn as a kind of a beginner player. Malo has really perfected it to the next level. Helped by a little bit of a net. Daniel Gonzalez picks up another point.
Seven.
Clinical textbook, classic Malo shot, big forehand, right into the body of the other player. You see Wang Chuqing standing, getting ready for his next match, the third match.
Seven, three.
Daniel Gonzalez, same great serve attack sequence as he's done earlier in the match as well. Great way for him to pick up points and demonstrate all that he can do on the biggest stage.
8-3.
Malo's serves are just so perfect. That serve landed right, I think, on the white line of the end. It's really, for Malo, for me, it's a master class in this very simple serve, the first serve you learn at the highest level.
Four. Hey.
Daniel Gonzalez picking up that next point.
Five. 4-9.
Looks like Daniel here is looking to do kind of like a serve attack. And it's the right choice. It's been working very well. Sometimes it's when you're playing someone who is the world number two, formerly world number one in Go, you might tend to overplay that attack. But really, you should just play what you want to, what you normally train, right? And that's what you want to demonstrate at the biggest stage of table tennis. Six match points for Ma Long. Looking to close it out here and give China that 2-0 team lead, but not yet. I know Gonzalez saves first match point. Ma Long has five more. And not the second one either. Both of those points earned by Daniel Gonzalez, Ma Long missed an attack. Unusual territory for the GOAT. But not on the serve receive. That's all he needs to take this game. 11-6, 3-0 for Ma Long against Daniel Gonzalez from Puerto Rico, giving Team China a 2-0 lead. And some nice applause from the crowd here. Excited to see kind of their national heroes doing a good job in today's opening round. So the final score for the second match in this team tie, 3-0 for Ma Long, 11-6, 11-2, 11-6. You know, and he feels like his job is done. So coming up, we get to see a newer star from China, Wang Chuqing, a lefty. I saw him first in action at the World Championships in Houston last year. And Angel Naranjo from Team Puerto Rico coming up next.
Welcome back to the high-tech sports center for the 2022 World Team Championships Finals. China up against Puerto Rico. It is 2-0 to the Chinese. But they've given a pretty good account of themselves so far, haven't they, Barbara?
Absolutely. I mean, taking some leads even in the game.
Yep.
And they should be proud of how they've performed.
Yep, the 3-0 in each match maybe doesn't quite tell the full story. Of course, China have been absolutely dominant, but both these players, Brian Affanato and Daniel Gonzalez, have done themselves proud.
Yeah, they can take a lot of these learnings back to Puerto Rico. And it just feels great to play someone that you otherwise may never have an opportunity to play outside of the World Championships.
Yeah, precisely. Angel Naranjo is up against Wang Chuqing in the third match. Of course, if Wang can complete this, then it is all over, this tie.
Yeah.
So Wang won the toss, but he will receive. Here is Angel Naranjo. He is just 18 years of age, 186th in the world, his current ranking, 7 years a pro. And he has got his work cut out for him. Certainly. He's the third member of this trio that have come from Puerto Rico to the World Team Championships.
7 years a pro, only 18 years old.
It's been a long time to be a pro. I mean, at that age. Wang Chuqin, he's 22 years of age, a left-hander. He's currently 11th in the world. He's 8 years a pro, two tournament wins under his belt. He's also got three world championships. A team event in 2018, doubles in 2019, the mixed doubles in 2021. And this is the first meeting, unsurprising perhaps. His highest ranking has been 10th in the world, Wang Chuqin, and 182nd in the world, Angel Naranjo. So it's not too far away from his best ranking. A much taller man. You'll need all the advantage you can get, I suppose.
And then Team Puerto Rico has come to this match with quite a positive mindset, really. Show the world what you can do, learn from this experience. And also keep fighting, don't give in.
I mean, look, you take a leaf out of the book from the previous two. They've set a pretty decent bar because they took points off their opponents. There was a lead at some point. And as you say, concentrate on yourself first. Worry about what you can do.
Right, don't worry about your opponent and who they are right. And trying to overplay or outplay them. Just do you.
Just do you. Let's see how we can do it. I mean, He's a teenager.
Game,
he's got to be nervous, this guy.
Angel Naranjo.
I like the positivity.
Yeah, they are. They're just all of Team Puerto Rico has come out showing us what they can do.
Yeah, he's willing to stand up and try and deliver if he can, Angel.
And Wang Chuqin, compared to Ma Long and Fan Zhengzheng, has not had as much experience.
Right.
Much newer on the international circuit. Also looking to prove himself to the Chinese national team.
That's a good point. He's a former youth Olympic gold medalist in 2018. Asian Games gold medalist as well. And he's got bronze at the WTT Cup Finals last year in Singapore.
And he won gold at the WTT Star Contender in Budapest this summer.
He's got a very good start here, Wang Chuqin. Edge there from Naranjo.
Seven love.
So, seven love at the moment. So, no points yet, and I'm sure he'd like to get something on the board. Angel Naranjo.
And there it is.
9-1.
So it's first point. But he's been very good so far, Wang Chuqin. This is absolutely clinical at the moment, isn't it?
It's clinical, and I think Wang Chuqin looks more focused than his opponents because he is kind of proving
himself. Is that because of where he is in comparison to them? Yep. Well, one love. Yeah, I think that's very fair, what you're saying. A little bit more to prove, perhaps. He's looked good, hasn't he, Wang Chuqin? And he's won that first game 11-1.
En cualquier deporte jaqueta es que la bola tiene que ir cuando no está el otro. Y tú le estás poniendo la bola donde le está. Manda para allá, para la derecha, identifica bien el servicio. Vete en banana para el carajo o córtale profundo. No todo el tiempo esa mierda, corto, porque... Sí.
Oye.
So Wang Chuqin seems to be a man on a mission at the moment.
Isn't it exciting for him to play a World Championships at home?
Mm. Second game, China to serve.
And as representing the team of China, which is different than when we saw him in action in Houston.
Love all. One love.
It's also difficult to play Wang Chuqin. He's a lefty, he has good serves. He's very explosive when he plays. It's no easy task for Naranjo.
One all.
Yeah. Well, one all, that's better already. I mean, I guess what you're looking to is at least improve from the previous game, right?
And that, he has.
And he has already, absolutely.
One, two.
That's great rally.
These are the kind of rallies that he'd love to have more of. And he stood up there, didn't he? Again.
Doing Puerto Rico proud. It feels so good to stay in a rally with a Chinese national team member just counter-looping and counter-looping.
Right.
If I can do that, I can beat anyone. You can feel like that.
I'm trying to go for shots, perhaps just... played that a little too quick. Some might say snatched at it.
One, five.
He's going for shots, isn't he?
Yeah. It's so refreshing to see Team Puerto Rico not intimidated at all.
Right.
They're here to show the world what they can do. You can make a nice clip for your Instagram.
Right. Yeah, this is the kind of stuff that get a good point against a top Chinese player, that could go viral. Yeah, it's not as if there's a reluctance or a nervousness about trying to play the shots. They are going for it.
They're going for it. And that is a great mindset to have. That's the best way you can gain the experience. It's also nice to see they're not overhitting their shots.
Right.
They're not trying to hit too hard and then making mistakes.
Another point.
Three.
On the board. for Angel Naranjo. Maybe those are the sort of errors he would be happy with, right? Angel Naranjo.
You know, it's hard to say. Wang Chuqin's serve is tough. You know, it's hard to say.
Fair. That's fair. Angel Naranjo's serves can be tough as well.
Yeah, just trading serve receives. Nice, surprising serves. Really, really fast. Kind of gutsy, too, right into the forehand. Wang Chuqin's forehand's just powerful. It's like a hammer.
8-4.
Wang Chuqin has a win percentage of 78%. He's won 100 out of 128 matches. That's very impressive. You look at his opponent. He's got possession of points, and Naranjo, 29%. 4 out of 14 matches. He's really inexperienced.
That's new. It's very new. But what a treat to be here.
Absolutely. He's taken 4 points off a top player. You can only get better.
Can only get better.
Yeah. 6 game points for Wang Chuqin.
And these are tie points as well. Not yet. They're not quite tie points yet.
Seeing into the future. It's a good shot. Lovely backhand there from Naranjo.
Love this fearlessness from Naranjo.
And he'll be
hit it from like under the table. It was kind of flat too.
I'd be absolutely delighted at the improvement he's made since the last game. It's now on to 7. There's only 3-point difference between
Ten
these two.
7. Left. 10-7.
And that is the game done. Wang Chuqin, but it was a slightly tougher one for him, with Naranjo doing well at times. Some nice shots, brave shots as well.
I'd love to see that he's going for all the shots. Giving Wang Chuqin a little bit of pressure.
Yeah, absolutely. Wang Chuqin there takes the second game 11-7. He's 2 up here in this match.
Eso mismo, pero inclina un poquito porque lleva bastante y la bola no se te está quedando en la malla, está saliendo.
Ahora la voy a bajar un poquito y jugar con la bolita. En verdad no me está haciendo nada.
Exacto. Pero ya te diste cuenta que en el baja hicimos 3 puntos cogidos, ¿no? Sí. Muy bien, perfecto. Y procura que esa primera pelota lleve bastante calidad. O como tú creas, vamos. Pero no, te veo jugando muy bien, ¿eh?
So into the third and potentially final game here between Wang Chuqin and Angel Naranjo.
Last one.
So we had a procession of points in that first game, Wang Chuqin, but he found it a little bit tougher against Angel Naranjo in the second.
And we'll see if that pattern continues into the third. And both players are the less experienced players on their team.
Yeah.
Wang Chuqin just looks, I mean, still very much in control, but slightly less in control than a Fen Zhendong or Ma Long.
1-0. One. 3. Timeout.
So a timeout call there by Puerto Rico.
And look at the solidarity on the Chinese team. Everyone stands. It's really a team effort here.
Entonces, ¿qué tienes que hacer? Dale tiempo a esa pelota y desventajala. Porque por alguna razón, que no sé, parece que saben lo que vamos a hacer también. Y tú me habías dicho a mí, voy a dejar la jaqueta aquí, ¿verdad? Sí. Entonces, lo que te están exponiendo te la hay. Ahora necesitamos la fuerza. Ahí, papi. Mira, el servicio corto a la derecha ahorita dio punto. ¿Eh?
Dio punto.
¿Lo sorprendemos al bajón o lo vamos con el mismo y después lo sorprendemos?
Lo va a sorprender ahora.
En este momento, uno y uno. Uno corta a la derecha y uno largo al bajón.
Va a ser largo.
Ok.
One, three.
At this point, Barbara, for Ángel Naranjo, I think the result is probably almost beyond doubt. It's about going on and I guess enjoying the occasion now, right?
Right, just having some fun with it. Enjoy the lights, enjoy playing against Wang Chuqin from Team China, and enjoy gaining this experience.
Four, because who knows when you might ever get this opportunity again.
Absolutely. You know, it's funny to see the reactions when teams draw China in their draw. Some teams are really excited and some teams are not happy about it.
Nicely done there by Naranjo on the backhand. He's only one behind. He looks a bit annoyed at himself now, Wang Chuqin.
Yeah, Wang Chuqin does look a bit annoyed. Now the real key is if we'll see Team China call a timeout. That would mean that Naran just really put the pressure on.
Yeah. Well, for the first time in this match, Ángel Naranjo has actually taken the lead. And that's a special moment for him.
It really is. It really is. And it shows this dedication to not giving up.
Well, that timeout, since then, I think he's reeled off 4 points in a row. It's been excellent.
And like I said, the real test, if Team China calls that timeout, you have rattled them.
Just wonder when or if they pull that trigger. Well, well, well. It is a 3-point lead. Might be the biggest lead in this entire tie.
I think it has been the biggest lead.
He's won 6 of the last 8. That just shows you.
7-5.
I just wonder if that switches it.
Right, that was the end of the streak. That was a very interesting streak. Wang Chuqin missed a couple backhands. Looks like he lost focus for a bit. Let's see if he can bring it back. Or if Naranjo has some more tricks up his sleeve.
Well, he's standing and delivering again. He's happy to go up against his opponent. Blow for blow.
Naranjo trying to see if he can get a game.
Oh, he's so unlucky there. Naranjo looked like he was on top on that rally. He had Wang Chuqin on the ropes for a bit.
Wang Chuqin looks relieved to have won, honestly.
He adjusted himself well when that clipped the net, didn't he?
Really did. I think Naranjo just barely clipped the net on that one as well.
This is starting to look dicey for Wang Chuqin. No timeout yet.
No timeout. And again, the coaches know the players best. Sometimes maybe it's good to wait and see if they can adjust on their own.
9-7.
Well, this is the most pressure any of the Chinese players has faced so far in any of the matches, any of the games, in fact.
Oh,
Now that pressure might start to get to Naranjo because he thought he might just see the finish line. He's getting tugged back, isn't he?
And Team China is so well trained. I mean, they practice for things like this. They practice for the end game.
To think this young man lost 111 just a few minutes ago.
Eight.
He's now got Wang Chuqin at 9-8. This is brilliant. What a turnaround. This is, again, speaks volumes for the team. He's putting him under pressure. That's a great way to bring up game point here for Angel Naranjo.
And look how happy this Puerto Rican team is standing on their feet.
First time we've seen that today from them.
That's right. They're on their feet, and they're so excited. I mean, what a story. It was 11-1 the first game.
What a turnaround this is. If they can get a game, that would be a story in itself. He's done it.
11-8.
Angel Naranjo has taken a game against Wang Chuqin. That is huge.
They are smiling on the Puerto Rican side. Really rose to the occasion. Naranjo, congratulations to him. That's something for your resume.
Look at that. He has won that third game 11-8. He has got better and better as this has progressed, as has actually every Puerto Rican player.
What a special moment for the team.
Such a great moment.
And now the fans for Team China feeling the pressure too.
Yeah, he can't be too pleased at the moment, Wang Chuqin. With all due respect to his opponent, these are matches he'd expect to win in straight games. I think that we have to set that context to be fair. That's the expectation set by Team China.
They are here to win 3-0, 3-0, 3-0, everything.
Yeah. So he'll want to set that right, and he's probably going to try and be as ruthless as possible. Mind you, Naranjo isn't going to give up without a big fight here.
He is not going to let that go. And it's really special about Team Puerto Rico. They're really spirited. Mm. They have that drive.
Love two.
Yeah, I just get the impression Wang Chuqin has decided, okay, I'm going to be as ruthless as I can now. I also have to sort of make a point here, Barbara, that after I dropped that game, I need to make a be quite emphatic now.
And that's what's happening. Wang Chuqin reestablishing himself in this fourth game. Wow, look at that slap from Naranjo. Just kind of a flat hit. Watch this, kind of adding power right into the middle.
One, five.
This is probably what most people thought would happen at the moment. Wang Chuqin and Angel Naranjo. But if you've just joined us, well, it's been a spectacular last game there from Naranjo, who took a game off Wang Chuqin. And he's now on his, got a second point here in game four.
6-2.
Much better from Wang Chuqin.
Now it feels clinical. Now it feels like I'm here, getting the job done.
This is more like game one, isn't it?
It feels much more like that.
Yeah.
And I just wonder for Angel Naranjo, has he kind of reached that high and he's maybe got a bit ahead of himself, or you know, maybe thought, oh, job done, I've got a game off him. I don't know.
Yeah, it could feel like job done.
Yeah.
I've accomplished my goal.
And it was a surprise, and then I'm now what do I do? Yeah.
What happens now?
Right. Missed that one. Wang Shuqin. Fourth point on the board for Angel Naranjo. Remember yesterday that Puerto Rico lost to Slovenia 3-1.
And they should be proud of how they are playing today.
And actually, we must add that Angel Naranjo was the only one who won his match yesterday. So certainly an up-and-coming talent. And the match point is done.
Wang Chuqin
has restored order there as far as he's concerned. But it wasn't without a hiccup. After two very dominant games, Naranjo's pushed him in the other two, took one of those.
Great play by Team Puerto Rico throughout this whole team tie, and congrats to Naranjo for taking that game.
Yeah, that is something I think he will never, ever forget. This is going to be one of the highlights of his, I could think of quite a long, nice career, hopefully, for him. But Wang Chuqin has won this. We have to put that into context. He has won this against Angel Naranjo. 11-1, 11-7, 8-11, 11-4. And that brings us to the end of this tie. And perhaps, again, when we look at this, Barbara, it may not tell the full story, but plenty of credit to Puerto Rico.
Plenty of credit. They came out here swinging, fighting with the right spirit. But it is China in the end, 3-0. Moving on to their next round-robin match.
Yep. In about an hour and a half, just over an hour and a half from now, we're going to have China again in action. They're up against Canada, who are going to be right up against it. It's going to be perhaps a similar story to what we saw here between Puerto Rico and Team China, but it's Team Canada who are taking on Team China. Sun Yingsha on the roller there. They are the team to beat in the women's category as well. So 7 p.m. local time. Do stay with us for all that action. And let's just remind you of what we've seen so far. Team Chinese Taipei beating Team Romania 3-1 this morning. It was the same scoreline as Sweden defeated England. And then we've just seen China thrash overall Puerto Rico. Let's find out what happens between China and Canada and the women's side of things in an hour and a half. From Barbara Way and Misha Zadhak, thanks a lot for joining us. We'll see you in a while.